Hi there. I'm trying to save a file from Word into a SharePoint site. The problem is I can't find the site when I'm going to save in Word. So how can we fix this? I'm going to show you in this video how we can do that, how you can actually save to a site that you're not seeing through Word, and what the secret behind it all could be. All right, so this is actually a workaround. Maybe at some point Microsoft will make some changes in this area, so we won't need the workaround, but for now let's try it this way. So what you're seeing in front of you is the Save As screen in Word, and you'll see that I have frequent sites that I frequently go to according to Microsoft, and then I have sites that I'm following according to Microsoft. And the one that I'm missing that I want to save to is a site that's called Classroom. So just to prove that it is missing, I'm going to take you into SharePoint real quick just so you can see it there and then see it's missing from here. So hang on a sec. So if you look, I'm on my SharePoint site here. If you look on the left-hand side of the screen, there's a number of things showing. It says what I'm following again. So it doesn't say frequent like Word does, it says recent. And then at the bottom of recent, notice that there's a see all, so there could be more, and that's where you can see all your sites in one little screen. So the one I'm not seeing in Microsoft Word that I wanna save to is under Classroom. So by the way, I am assuming that with the SharePoint site we're talking about, you're getting to the SharePoint site by using one Microsoft account, one login to Microsoft. Okay, so we see my sites. Let's go out of there. And then I'll show you what I'm trying to do. So I'm just gonna go back to my documents. So here's my test document. I wanna save this file into the Classroom SharePoint site. So if I go File, Save As, and I go to Sites on the left. So first off, this has to be there. So as long as you logged in at some point into your Microsoft site, you should be seeing the site there. If you're not seeing this, you might check with your IT department or IT people about making sure it's there, or just log in by adding a place here and then going through the prompts from Microsoft for your login and your password. Okay, so let's just assume it's there. I'm gonna click on that. And that's the same screen you saw me start in. So how do we get it showing here? We're going to kind of do a workaround here. So our workaround involves us using the browse feature. I'm going to hit the browse, and now it's looking at my file structure on my computer. So this is assuming that you have synced at least one of your SharePoint sites or folders to your desktop. I have to assume that. So if you have, then what you're going to see when you browse is the SharePoint site in your list on the left. So Mission Computers is my SharePoint site name, not to be confused with OneDrive. And so it has this little icon that looks like a building, right? So let's click on that. And as you see, Classroom is not showing there. It's showing only a few of my sites. So you saw on the other screen, I had lots of sites. I'm not syncing all of those sites to my desktop. I don't want to. That's your option, whether you sync as many sites as you want. But I do want to be able to save to that Classroom one. So as long as I know the address of that Classroom SharePoint site, I can save to it. So that address is showing up top here. And it's a little bit different than a file path address. So let's just show you how to find that address. I'm gonna move out of here for a second. And I'm gonna go back to my SharePoint site. And I want you to notice that your SharePoint site has an address at the beginning of it that really is your company name or organization name, followed by a .sharepoint.com. Okay, so make note of that because that's how your address starts. And then what you're gonna do is pick the site that you wanna go to. So let's say I wanna go to Classroom. So I'm gonna click on Classroom. And now notice that the name is missioncomputers.sharepoint.com/sites/classroom. So this is the address we want to use when trying to go to this site to save our file. So I'm gonna copy this address. And now in my file save box, when I'm on the Mission Computers SharePoint site, which is just, again, not giving me Classroom, I'm gonna click at the top here and paste in what I did there, hit enter, and now it's gonna try and bring up that site, the site contents for me. So it's kind of showing you an interesting screen here. I'm going to assume that your files are in the documents area of the site. If they're on a different page, you'd need to go find that page. If they're just in the documents area under files, then we can click on documents here, actually give it a double click, and now you see the folders that are on that in that SharePoint site. Right, so I'm in Classroom right now and I'm seeing the folders or the file structure. So I want to save into General. I've done a couple of tests, as you can see. I'm going to say this is test number 3 for video. Okay, and I'm going to hit Save. Okay, so test number 3 for video. And I'm going to close this. Now I'm going to just go back to that Classroom site. So let's just go the long way. So I'm in SharePoint. I want to go to Classroom, and here's my documents over here. So if I go to General, then there's test 3 for video. And if I click on that, that'll open up that file on the web, trying to save to the Classroom site. Now, if you're using Teams, let's just show you how this looks in Teams as well. So let's open up a Teams window. So here's my Teams window. If I click on Classroom, team name is the same as the site name. So Classroom is the team, General is the folder that I wanted, that I saved into, and then Files will be where that file is. And Test 3 for video is right there. Okay, I mean, that's one way. I mean, there's many ways of saving files from Word into Microsoft Teams or into your SharePoint site. So if you want other methods of doing this, then please check out one of my other videos on how to save files within your Teams environment. All right, so thanks very much. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.